in the past 24 hours, we have seen that 1,648 cases have been reported, and this is one of the highest numbers as far as the single day spike is concerned. The government is optimistic at best at this point in time. The government is saying that the growth is linear and not exponential, which means that it is steadily rising. It's not rising in a way which cannot be contained, which cannot be controlled, is what the government is feeling right now. The only good news that is coming in from the numbers is that the recovery rate is significantly increased over the past 20 days. We have seen that the recovery rate, which was pegged at approximately 10%, has now crossed 20%. In fact, at this point in time, the recovery rate of the patients in as far as the entire country is concerned has reached to 20.57%, and more than 4,700 people have recovered from this disease. But still, a worrying trend for the government just 10 days ahead of the lockdown to end is that how to contain the cases and how to flatten the curve. And to flatten the curve, it will take the government to increase the number of recoveries as compared to the number of new cases are concerned. So still a long task, a big task ahead of the government, but at this point in time, what we can say is that the government needs to ramp up its work as far as flattening the curve is concerned, Divya.
Right, Akshay. Now, also in Delhi's Azadpur Mandi, nearly 300 shops have remained closed because two more people have tested positive. One earlier died of the coronavirus. So, Akshay, what details do you have about this?
Well, Divya, Azadpur Mandi is one of the largest fruit and vegetable market, not only in India, but it is considered one of the largest market in all of Asia. We have seen that earlier the government was trying to ask the people to not go to Azadpur Mandi directly if they do not have a very pressing issue, very urgent matter, and they were asking lesser number of people to go. Even an odd and even scheme was implemented in Azadpur Mandi, but we saw that 2 days back a trader of vegetable died due to the complications of coronavirus, and after that on Wednesday we saw that two new cases emerged, one of a trader of fruits and vegetables, and the second case was of his daughter. So after that, there is a fear and there is a sense of panic in the people, in the traders especially, who still have to go every day to Azadpur Mandi, and there is a huge footfall every day. So as far as the shutting down of markets are concerned, shutting down of shops are concerned, it has taken place at the Block D of Azadpur Mandi, and approximately 292 shops have been shut down, and the traders are saying that until unless the government does not ramp up the testing work and ramp up the efforts to contain the virus in that particular area, they will not be willing to open up the markets. Now this is a worrying trend because not only in the national capital, Azadpur Mandi is linked to the supply of vegetable and fruits in this entire region. So if Azadpur Mandi goes down, this will be a major supply halt for fruits and vegetable in this entire region, including the national capital, Dubai.